What's happening, YouTube? Cowboy here, and it is officially time to get started off with Wicked Eyes and Wicked Hearts. So first and foremost, I wanted to apologize real quick because I noticed after the fact that parts 55 and 56 of the walkthrough basically disappeared. In short, I had recorded them all before I had to travel for work this weekend, and basically I had so many videos uploading that, like, YouTube logged me out halfway through, so they never uploaded, and I didn't notice this until it was too late, and, you know, I was cleaning out old uploads, and to help counter this, of course, we do have the drunk through going on, and we're actually just barely outside of that mission on the drunk through. So, to make it up to you guys, when we get to that part of the drunk through, the whole sequence of what happens in the rift will be uploaded in place of those two parts of the walkthrough. Aside from that, though, everything is continuing as normal. You know, we went into the rift right at the end of episode 54, two parts in the rift, and then after that we went towards Emerald Graves. So obviously you missed what happened in the rift. You guys will get that by this weekend, sometime on Saturday, which actually will probably be when this video is going live. But either way, let's get kicked off. You know, main story time, Wicked Eyes and Wicked Hearts, recommend level 12 to 15. We're way over leveled at this point because we've been doing all kinds of shit. So without further ado, let's get started on the main story.
You have to reach the Empress before Corypheus. The only question is, how?
We know how. I have our way in. The real question is, where is our enemy hiding? At the urging of Grand Duchess Florian, the Empress is holding a ball. Absolutely everyone will be there. During the festivities, Celine will be meeting for peace talks with the usurper Duke Gaspard and Ambassador Briala.
The assassin must be hiding within one of these factions.
Let's go.
We shouldn't waste any time. Let's go to the Winter Palace.
I'll show this an assassin what a real assassin does. Sarah, my dear. Vivian, you'll do fantastic in court. And Iron Bull. Now, I gotta say, I was thinking about it too. If you're playing as an assassin rogue, this very well may be the most powerful party in the game. Because assassin, the abilities of an assassin are fucking OP. You know, Mark has the highest damaging potential. Just because it can take the damage from other moves and combine them all into one. You have tons of damage out of hidden blades. Moving on to Tempest, you're basically a god, you know. No cooldown costs, no cooldowns, no costs on your spells. You can spam hidden blades, which is the hardest hitting ability. You know, you can freeze time with Lightning Flask. You go over to Knight Enchanter, and I don't even need to say anything about that. That's just, like, face roll powerful. And then you have Reaver, which you have so much lifesteal, nothing can kill you. And I wasn't really thinking about it until now, but really brutal combination.
Halamshiral hangs by a thread. The Empress fears our presence could sever it. The Grand Duke is only too happy to have us at the ball as his guests, so our invitation comes from him. Whether we act as his allies or upset the balance of power, he gains an opportunity, if not a clear advantage.
Oh, snap!
It is a great pleasure to meet you, Inquisitor Lavellan.
I look good as hell.
The rumors coming out of the Western Approach say you battled an army of demons. Imagine what the Inquisition could accomplish with the full support of the rightful Emperor of Orlais.
And which one was the rightful one again? I keep getting them confused.
The handsome, charming one, of course, my lady. I am not a man who forgets his friends, Inquisitor. You help me, I'll help you. My lady, are you prepared to shock the court by walking into the Grand Ball with a hateful usurper? They will be telling stories of this into the next age.
I can't imagine that crowd has seen anything better than us in their entire lives.
You're a woman after my own heart.
No, trust me, I'm not, bro.
Perhaps there is a matter you could undertake this evening. This elven woman, Briala, I suspect that she intends to disrupt the negotiations. My people have found these ambassadors all over the fortifications. Sabotage seems the least of their crimes.
Tell me there's more to your suspicion than the elves were acting dodgy.
That ambassador, Briala, used to be a servant of Selene's. That is, until my cousin had her arrested for crimes against the Empire, to cover up a political mistake. If anyone in this room wishes Selene harm, Inquisitor, it's that elf. She certainly has reason. Be as discreet as possible. I detest the game, but if we do not play it well, our enemies will make us look like villains. We're keeping the court waiting, Inquisitor. Shall we?
Man, I'm all about the game. Tear up political intrigue.
Inquisitor. An elf savage! Oh, make a forbid!
An elf savage? Orlesian nobles look down on elves. The court watches you with a critical eye.
You there! Rabbit! Have you seen a ring anywhere? It was a gift from the Countess Montbelliard, enchanted by the Fomari. I cannot go into the vault without it.
That's a terrible predicament.
If the Countess finds out, make her have mercy. Should you happen upon it, I beg you, let me know. What am I going to do if I cannot find my ring?
What? Court approval minus 5? Why is it telling me I gained court approval? Oh no, I did.
A treasure! I cannot believe you found it! You have saved me a lifetime of mortification. How can I thank you enough?
That was weird. It looked like it was minus 5, but apparently I'm at 35 out of 100, so... Hooray! Making progress. Ah, just a codex.
Gaspar never struck me as pious. He must think he gains military advantage with the Inquisition. Where has that servant gone?
Out the door.
Always shirking their duties.
Out of my way. The Inquisitor must search for a Hala statue.
It's been too long since I've had any word from Valoyou.
Bingo! What secrets are hiding in here? A dagger and crap. Wow. You figure there'd be like something useful in there, you know, like documents or I don't know, something.
Where has that servant gone?
Bah. I have a storage key.
This is a private conversation. Please, leave.
Whatever, dick. I'm gonna go all Assassin's Creed. Just hop on top, right here. They'll never see me, I'm walking on the ledge. Oh, I fell. Oh, there we go.
Any word from the front lines?
My spies said the bodies were beyond counting.
Surely the Empress will put an end to the war tonight.
Pray, my friend. If the Maker does not hear us now, just pray.
Alright, well, I guess that's everything. Kind of like to figure out what's in that room, but I've been pinging a lot and I haven't seen a storage key, so...
Inquisitor, a moment, if you please. I must warn you before you go inside. How you speak to the court is a matter of life and death. It is no simple matter of etiquette and protocol. Every word, every gesture is measured and evaluated for weakness.
Don't they sound delightful? I'm shocked we haven't invited the court to dinner at Skyhold.
The game is like Wicked Grace played to the death. You must never reveal your cards. When you meet the Empress, the eyes of the entire court would be upon you. You are safer in the Fade with the Fear Demon.
Ha! Huh.
You're just full of joy and light this evening.
Everything will be fine.
Yeah, fantastic. Horror? That's just... be cool if there was like a compendium of all those little things you could read through them. Oh man, now we just gotta get through some load screens. Gotta love those load screens. Winter Palace.
If nothing else, the Inquisition back in Gaspar.
The guest wing is not open to the public. No.
Here we go. Another eavesdrop thing.
Just gossip.
Is that you?
Interesting. I had no idea.
Scandalous secrets gathered? Ugh. That sounds like it could be a big pain in the ass to grab 30.
Who does Orzammar favor in the negotiations tonight?
Really, Josephine? Right now? You want to report in this second? We're a little busy at the moment.
Can Gaspar take the
How could the Empress afford to renovate the palace without what we're going on?
I heard that it wasn't a renovation against us.
It will take some time to get our men.
I can hardly believe Gaspar is here.
And everyone in their masks.
And now presenting Grand Duke Gaspard de Chalon and accompanying him Lady Inquisitor Lavellen.
What's up, bitches?
Shepherd and Leash of the Wayward Order of Templars. Purger of the heretics from the ranks of the faithful.
He is so full of it. That's not how it went.
Champion of the blessed Andraste herself.
Did you see their faces? Priceless.
Accompanying the Inquisitor, Madame Vivienne, first enchanter of the Circle of Magi, enchanter of the Imperial Court, mistress of the Duke of Ghislaine, the Iron Bull, leader of the famed mercenary company Bull's Chargers, as the name might imply. Her ladyship, my bulls each, of course. Sir Callum of Homley,
yo,
command of the
fucking Sarah.
Inquisition,
oh my God.
Former knight commander of Kirkwall. Lady Liliana.
Oh man.
Imperial Court. Veteran of the Fifth Blight, Seneschal of the Inquisition, and Left Hand of the Divine. And Lady Josephine Charette Montillier of Antiva City, Ambassador of the Inquisition.
Mind the balls itch, of course. Oh my God, I'm so glad. So real quick, I'd actually started recording this episode, and I got like up to this part pretty much, and I didn't realize when you walk up there, it just progresses and he cuts off the announcements. And I had gotten up to Iron Bull and I was like, well, what does he say for Sarah? You know, how's he going to introduce Sarah? She's like, she's the, she's part of like the Red Jennies. So I restarted the mission just to get to hear that. And God, it was so fucking worth it. So glad I restarted. That was, oh man, that was glorious. That was so glorious.
My dear sister.
Grand Duke, we are always honored when your presence graces our court.
Don't waste my time with pleasantries, Celine. We have business to conclude.
We will meet for the negotiations after we have seen to our other guests.
Inquisitor?
Lady Inquisitor, we welcome you to the Winter Palace. Allow us to present our cousin, the Grand Duchess of Leeds, without whom this gathering would never have been possible.
What an unexpected pleasure. I was not aware the Inquisition would be part of our festivities. We will certainly speak later, Inquisitor.
I don't like her. She's fishy.
Like a cool wind on a summer's day.
Let's hope the breeze does not herald an oncoming storm.
Even the wisest mistake fair winds for foul. We are at the mercy of the skies, Inquisitor. How do you find Halam Shiral?
I've never seen anything to equal the Winter Palace.
We hope you will find time to take in some of its beauties. Feel free to enjoy the pleasures of the ballroom, Inquisitor. We look forward to watching you dance.
Inquisitor, a word when you have a moment.
Court approval's up to 40.
It's true. The Templars have returned.
Inquisitor?
Josephine! Oh, Josephine! Is this her?
Inquisitor, please allow me to present to you my younger sister, Yvette Gabriella Montillier.
There can never be too many Lady Montilliers in Thedas, can there?
Inquisitor, I've heard so much about you, but not as much as I want. Josephine writes, but she never tells me anything. Is it true you found the Red Templars sacrificing heretics and drinking blood from mages' veins?
Yvette?
Everyone in Antiva City is saying so. Is it true?
Oh, it was awful. Mage bones everywhere, practically a carpet of skulls over a river of blood.
Ew. How awful.
This may be my only chance to hear about when Josephine was a girl.
Oh, yes. As she told you about when she was 10 and...
Yvette, stop.
Fine. What about when we were climbing the cliffs by the...
No.
She once told the Duke of...
Absolutely not.
Hmm. She still plays with her doll collection when no one's looking.
Yvette, that's absurd. Absolutely preposterous.
She's fun.
See you later.
Another time.
What were they doing?
Ah. I have hey there.
I have heard they are the finest in the Empire.
Extra
such
toes.
A pity the wings.
What a fun close marrying crowd.
Think I can get you to dance with me later?
On their precious tiles. That's a good one. Besides, I don't. That's not me, yeah? Couldn't be me.
Making any new friends?
Not likely. I'm watching them watch you. They're all glances and titters. Not sure if they're allowed to like you yet. Pathetic.
Any hidden treasures from friends of your little network?
You mean, do any of the servants ferrying tarts between these windy tits hate them enough to give up a stash or two? I'm not saying yes, but... Wait, yes I am. There's some good stuff hidden around. Keep an eye out.
Any thoughts on who we're investigating?
The Empress is pretty. It'd be fun to drink and kill stuff with Gaspard. Briala is friggin' funny. Elves, elves, elves. But it's really a pissing match with an old lover. Don't know the rest, but that explains a lot. They're all lying, but Celine's nice to look at. Good thing we're here to save her neck.
Back soon.
Not going.
Where did this guy just come from? We got Red Jenny stashes to hunt down. That'll be fun.
Get these pastries out to the diplomats.
The Duchess has asked for too many. I can't carry them all.
Vivian.
And here we are. You haven't embarrassed yourself as much as I feared. Well done, my dear.
I've always wondered, what's the Orlesian fascination with masks?
We all wear masks, my dear, not just the people in Orlais. Who you are as a daughter, a lover, a friend, are very different people from the Inquisitor and Herald of Andraste. Orlesians codify this truth, make it visible. By giving each of these selves its own separate face, they believe they can be their truest selves, unmasked.
Be ready to act when I give the signal.
Always, my dear.
I heard Celine was having the entire wing redecorated. But the time is atrocious.
Why would she do such a thing now?
Inquisitor, did you need something? The sooner we track down this infiltrator, the better.
All serious business, I see.
Have you noticed anything out of the ordinary?
Not yet. It would be easier if people would stop talking to me. Other people. Not you.
You've attracted a following. Who are all these people?
I don't know, but they won't leave me alone.
I take it you're not enjoying yourself.
At this point, the headache I'm developing is preferable to the company.
We'll talk later.
I await your signal.
Have you heard from your nephew?
Not since his regiment joined
the fight. Just dance with me, Commander. We cannot stand a battle with you, mate.
I'm afraid not. Thank you.
Man, Cullen's getting some good banter over there. I don't know where Bull's at, though.
Remember the day they...
Perhaps we can speak later, Inquisitor.
Well, I guess let's go through the door.
Good. I was hoping I would catch you. What did the Duke say?
He points the finger at Ambassador Briala.
The Ambassador is up to something, but she can't be our focus. The best place to strike at Celine is from her side. Empress Celine is fascinated by mysticism. Foreseeing the future, speaking with the dead, that sort of rubbish. She has an occult advisor. An apostate who charmed the Empress and key members of the court as if by magic. I've had dealings with her in the past. She is ruthless and capable of anything.
Wonder if they're talking about, Morrigan.
How can Celine openly keep an apostate in the Imperial Court?
The Imperial Court has always had an official position for a mage. Before now, it was little better than court jester. Vivian was the first to turn that appointment into a source of real political power. When the circles rebelled, technically every mage became an apostate. The word lost much of its strength.
You think she's controlling the minds of the court? That's powerful blood magic.
She's worth investigating. Can't be sure of anything here. Both leads point toward the guest wing. It's a promising place to start. I'll coordinate with our spies to see if I can find anything better. I will be in the ballroom if you need me.
I think it's Morrigan. Almost positive it'll be Morrigan.